The final voting for announcement, USA.
You were so central to his being.
At trial, he used to call home every night and read to you.
And we do thank you for doing
that. He adored you. He just adored you.
Thank you. I'm going to the childhood home where I grew up with my mom and dad in Minneapolis. When I got this assignment, he just immediately came to my mind. Of course, my dad, of course. Who changed me? Him. When I tell people my dad died at 49, they say, I'm so sorry, you were so young. I say to them, I had more of a dad in 15 years than a lot of kids ever get.
He managed to pack 100 years of living into 50 years. He was just kind of a wild man. You know, he had lots of energy.
What in him do you see in me?
You are both dedicated workers. You were just, you know, ever since you were a little girl, you were just a hard-driving little charger. It was a challenge to pry, it is a challenge still to pry you away from your work, and it was a challenge to pry Dad away from his work, too.
My dad was a trial lawyer, and he loved it. The work was all-consuming, but he prioritized us, family, and managed to hold on to the most important things in life. Every morning, he would wake up 4:35 a.m., drive me to skating practice, and then he would go to work. You know, it didn't matter what he had going on, how tired he was always there for me.
This is the picture of your third birthday party.
And he's still in his suit.
And he's still
like
in his
just
suit.
Like he just ran in the
that's
house.
That's right, that's right. He ran across three airports and he kept saying to the people who were with him, I've got to make it home for Poppy's birthday. I've got to make it home for her birthday.
He took me to the office a lot, right?
He did. And that's a picture you made one Saturday morning at the office. He saw every piano recital you did, every skating show. Yeah, he was a wonderful father. He was really your model. I mean, you're your father's daughter, without a doubt.
This is Columbia, where I went to college. It's where my dad went to school, and I wanted to follow in his footsteps and be like him. I even found my college application essay that I wrote about him. I learned what nobility really means from watching my father struggle so hard to live, never complaining, never lashing out in his pain, and always thanking everyone for their help. In the end, my father taught me the answer to a question I had never posed, how to die. My father died with dignity and love, knowing that he had left nothing undone.
Welcome back to St. Paul.
Thanks.
In Minneapolis.
You guys all look the same.
Well, of course we do.
My dad's partners at the law firm were like a second family to us, especially after he died.
You say about everybody, well, there's no one like him. I mean, you can't even get anything close to Jim, seriously.
In those days, you just sort of put your head down and plowed forward, but Jim was different. He actually made the time to make sure that he was there for you.
He knew when he was spending time with you to devote 100% to it, and he knew when he was working to devote 100% to it. You know, even though he was, you know, a well-respected partner high up in the organization, nothing was beneath Jim. We were trying a case once, and Jim walked into the workroom. It was about 2 a.m. He just picked up a stack of papers and started copying. And the paralegal had to say, you know, go back to bed, Jim. You need to be on your feet in the morning. But that's what he would do. I mean, nothing was above him and nothing was below him.
Hey, you.
Hey, you too.
Your interviews are really a reflection of your dad, I think. I mean, I see some of the same things, you know, the persistence, the nuance. You catch things that other people wouldn't catch. Watching you today, I mean, it would have been incessant. He would have been in the office. Yeah. Did you see Poppy last night? Did you see?
We would have had a CNN TV channel on every room in the office.
Yeah, so, exactly.
You know, he would want you to enjoy life as much as he did. He would want you to find joy in everything every day. He lived 49 years, but my goodness, he had more fun than probably 100 people in 100 lifetimes.
This is where I worked with your dad. I first started working with him before I even went to law school, right after I graduated from college. And I wanted to tell you what your dad had done for me and the gifts he gave me. I think that there's some people that come into your life and help you learn how to be a human being, a better human being, and I really think that your dad was one of those people for me.
Do you see any of him in me?
So much. You know, your dad's extraordinary listening comes through in you. Your dad let his heart be a part of his passion And I think you do that too.
Hi everyone, thank you so much for being with me. I'm Poppy Harlow in New York. Every day I want to make him proud because he did so much for me. His death spurred me to want to do better. His death made me want to achieve. I remember going into my freshman year of high school 9 days after he died, and the school said, well, you don't need to come, you can take some time off, but I just wanted to dive in.
Does it feel smaller?
It doesn't feel smaller. I feel a little bit older. But
it's a lot. Frank Sachs was my high school college counselor.
I have a copy of my recommendation that I wrote for you when you applied to college. I said you had real inner strength, self-discipline, that you had overcome tragedy because, you know, your dad had just died. That's actually when we connected. Can I give you a hug?
I'll never forget the day that I found out I got into Columbia. I jumped around my house and I was so thrilled.
Almost identical. Yours from 2000 and Dad's from 1965. Yeah, you made your dad proud.
I wanted to be a lawyer just like my dad. I was so set on being like him that I forgot for a while to be my version of him.
Girls who lose a father young tend to do extremely well, tend to be very ambitious because they're trying to offer this as a gift to their father who's gone. And you definitely did that, and you're still working hard, just like he did.
What would he tell me at 33 years old?
Relax and enjoy life a little more. Life is short and precious.
To live in the moment, that may be the core lesson my dad has left behind for me, and it is still one I'm trying to learn.
I still live a lot for what I need to accomplish, so it's a good reminder to me just to maybe focus me again on what matters, because he was only 16 years older than I am now when he died.
Quite a legacy, big guy. Quite a legacy. We're so happy that he lives on in you.
A total original, witty, honest, and kind. My dad was my cornerstone and the person who changed my life.